So in particular, if I want to tell something about a polynomial, an important property is a degree of the polynomial. So what is a degree of the polynomial? For demonstration purposes, let me take one example. Let us say my example is 3x cube plus 4x square y square plus 10y plus 1. This is my example. Let us say this is the example. So if I want to decide the degree of the polynomial, we have already seen each term itself is a polynomial. So 3x square is 1, 4x square y square is 1, 10y is 1, and this 1 is 1. So I want to identify the degree of each term as well. In each term, there are many variables. For example, you look at this term. If you look at this term, then there are two variables. So I want to have a complete understanding. So in order to define the degree of a polynomial, I will start with defining the degree of the variable. So the exponent on the variable in a term, the exponent on the variable in a term is called degree of that variable in that term. So for demonstration purposes, let us take the expression 4x square y square. So in this particular expression or in this particular monomial, how many variables are involved? One variable is x, second variable is y. So what I am saying is, now in this term, the degree of x, let me abbreviate it as degree, degree of x is 2, and the degree of y, variable y, is also 2. So this is how I will describe the degree of the variable. Now let us take this term as a term and say what is the degree of this term, right? So let me erase this particular portion, which is actually blocking our view. So the degree of that term, this term, we have already seen the degree of x is something and degree of y is something. Degree of x was 2 and degree of y was 2. The degree of the term is the sum of the degrees of that variable in that, of those variables in the term. That means the, if I look at this expression, which is 4x square y square, then and I ask for the degree of this term, then it is essentially degree of x plus degree of y, that is 2 plus 2, which is equal to 4. So degree of this term, the second term in this expression, is 4. Now we will answer the question, what is the degree of a polynomial? So the degree of the polynomial is the largest degree of among these all the terms, of any one of the terms with non-zero coefficients. All terms will exist only when there are non-zero coefficients. So let us try to see how we can solve this problem. So we will try to list all the degrees. So if I take the first term, that is 3x square, second term is 4x square y square, then the next term is 10y, and the last term is 1, which is a constant. Okay. So now we will talk in terms of degrees. So what is the degree of this particular term? It has only one variable x, which is raised to the second power. So the degree of this term is actually 2. What is the degree of this term? We have already seen here, the degree of this term is 4. What is the degree of this term? The degree of this term is again y, means y raised to 1, so the exponent is 1. Interesting. Now, what is the degree of this term? Now, remember, this is an expression in two variables, x and y. So, then I will ask a question, what is the degree of x and what is the degree of y? Now, you can also see that 1 into x raised to 0 into y raised to 0 is equal to 1. So, degree of x is naturally equal to 0 and degree of y is also equal to 0. Right? Therefore, I can write the degree of this expression is 0. Okay? Now, which one is the largest among these 4? 0, 1, 2, 4. 4 is the largest. So, the degree of this particular polynomial is 4. So, this degree is actually 4. Then write it here, 4. So, this is a polynomial of degree 4. Okay. So, in this contest, while finding the degree of this particular polynomial, we have seen two things. What are those two things? If the coefficient is, if the variable is x, then it is x raised to 1. If it's a constant, then c times x raised to 0. In our case, because the polynomial was having two variables, it is c times x raised to 0 into y raised to 0. Okay. Interesting question comes when we try to see polynomials at some other things. Let us say, if I want to describe 0, when c is non-zero, it's okay. But if c is 0, then what? Then you can see 0 is equal to 0 plus 0 times x plus 0 times x square plus 0 times x cube. The matter is complicated further and so on. Right? It will continue. So, if the point given then is number 0, then we will call this as 0 polynomial. And we cannot define the degree of this polynomial because for a degree, we need a non-zero coefficient. Just remember this in mind. Therefore, the degree of 0 polynomial is always undefined. This is an interesting fact which will be used when we use the division algorithm. The degree of 0 polynomial is undefined. So, you can use it in a more interesting manner. That's what I can say. So, the degree, this is what degree of 0 polynomial is undefined. So, we have understood what is the degree of the polynomial. So, in particular, based on the degrees, now we have introduced one classification. So, based on the degrees, how the polynomials can be classified. So, if the polynomial has degree 0, then it is constant and this constant can never be equal to 0. This is an important assumption. Then, if the polynomial is of degree 1, linear polynomial, then you will have a polynomial in this form. When I write this, then I should write a not equal to 0. If I have a quadratic polynomial, if the polynomial, okay, so here, these are the polynomials in one variable when I am considering a linear polynomial. If I am considering a polynomial of the form x plus y, this is still a linear polynomial, but it is a polynomial in two variables. So, you can also encounter such polynomials in linear. But the crucial fact is degree is 1. Second one is a quadratic polynomial which is of this form, and here you can have polynomial in two variables, three variables or whatever way you want. Then you will get a cubic polynomial which will have all terms containing degree 3. The highest term, highest monomial will have degree 3. So these are the examples of degree 3 polynomials. Similarly, degree 4 polynomials are called quartic polynomials and they will be given in this form. And similarly, degree 5 polynomials are called quintic or quantic polynomials, which will be represented with degree 5 polynomials. So the, and in general you have a general term which is called polynomial. So to be, if you want to be specific, you can use this classification and say it's a quadratic polynomial, then you are giving more information about it. This is what today's lecture meant to be. So we have introduced the topic of polynomials.